Hi all. Now that we know the generating set works and provides a good 24 volts, I've ordered some 24 volt bulbs, four of them, but also a socket, one of the metal surface mounting types, so it's got the surface mounting box with it as well. But something Dad found for me is this little aluminium box. It's a radio spares control box. So you can start from scratch and make your own system. So I think what I'll do with this, I was planning to have one mounted up like that. Yes, it is a bit of a mess, but it'll all be sorted out in due course. Anyway, something like that. It'll go on top, obviously lower down, and then the plug socket will be on there. Either that, or it'll go like that. But I'd rather not do that. So I think like that's going to be best. And I can have the cabling coming up inside, hidden in there, any connectors. That bulb could be hidden in there if that's still being used for resistance. So I think we should be able to do something with that. Right, well there we are, that's the box fitted. Unfortunately the stud there that was broken could not get out, so I cut it off flush and I just used the three bolts. It's perfectly strong, you can't move the box at the side at all, so it won't vibrate. And if I hadn't said, you'd never have known. So the cable goes up into the middle and the cable comes through at the back there, so it's quite well hidden. But I need to get a grommet in there, and I think I want to get rid of all this old insulating tape that's been put on there. I've got some heat shrinks, so I might use those to re-insulate some of this stuff. Particularly this one, it's breaking up. So, a bit of work to do there. And then I'll probably put a little junction box or something inside so that I can use fresh cable for the rest of it. So, the lid, bear with me one moment. With that on, it down, but that's what the box will look like. Right. Which I think looks reasonable. So it might just get polished rather than painted, because I doubt the paint would stick very well to this. So like I say, there's going to be an aluminium or steel, something like that, plug on the top, socket rather. Which I've ordered, and that'll probably take up quite a bit of space on there. That can be bolted to the top. I've got some nice brass bolts. So that will mean that I'm not having to drill too much. I actually did all this with a hand drill. Die cast aluminium is quite soft, so yeah, it's coming along. But you probably won't see any more information on this now for a little while, until all the other bits have arrived in the post and I've gone and bought all the extra bits I need. But when I have got all the bits and pieces, I'll do a test run and a video to show you it running some load. Hi all. A few little bits turned up for me from Radio Spares. Ordered these at about 3:30 yesterday, here by 11:30 this morning. Come from Northamptonshire. So they've come quite a long way, very quickly. Anyway, these are four bulbs I'm going to use. They're 25 watt, 24 volt, and they're screw fittings. But they should look really nice on my display. I'll put them on a board. I've got to be careful with those, they're not cheap. It's the trouble with special voltages, or those that are not so commonly used. But anyway, I'll go and get some bulb holders. I reckon the shop up the road will sell those, so I'll see what I can find. The other thing I got, this little socket, sort of industrial type, and with a switch. Not the prettiest, but I thought it would look better than the plastic type, and I wanted to avoid having to cut holes in this, because that's a bit difficult. So it doesn't look too bad, but it's not the prettiest. But I think it'll have to do. I mean, I can't really put it on the side, I don't think. Not enough room to do that. But certainly on the top somewhere should do. So I'll get that fitted. Got some very handy little brass bolts there. So that should do quite nicely. Well, you can see I put it on one end so as to avoid cluttering the control box a bit too much. So there's plenty of space for the wires, connections, that sort of thing. Got two holes there for the cable to come through, and got the four brass bolts holding it on, which have gone flush inside, so they shouldn't interfere with anything in there. That then goes on there like that, and I'm going to have to work out exactly how I wire that up. Should be easy. I think it's just those two. I don't need the earth here, I don't think. Though I might try and put an earth on, it's surprising what you can do with a few volts. So. But anyway, I'll get that fitted to the box. Well, that's the socket fitted now, nice and strong, doesn't move. And so that should be quite okay. Obviously not connected yet. I need to do a bit more testing before I actually wire it in, so I know what I actually need in here. Also just found a nice bit of black cable and a plug, so I put a 13 amp fuse in that, so we'll be drawing anything up to about 8 amps, that's the maximum. Two core cable, so that should do for now, and it gives me a little bit of length to play with. Don't want too much cable on the light box or it makes a bit of a mess. It's the problem with the other dynamo, it's very difficult to make that display look neat because there's just so much cable. So gotta get them bulb holders for these, but four of those mounted on a board should make quite a nice little display. And then if that's not enough load, I'll get another three, because four would take it just over the 190 something watt limit. About 200 watts I can draw, so probably seven bulbs would do nicely. So it's going to be a little while before I get to test this properly again, but as soon as I do, do a video of the testing, show how load affects the field, and then hopefully show you getting all this fitted up with the electronics. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.